Hi everyone, I'm Shilpa B, Assistant Professor of Department of ISC, Canara Engineering College. Today, let us see the Module 1 of Data Structure, where you are going to study something about the Introduction to Data Structure. These are the objectives and outcomes of data structures, Module 1. So, objective is explains the fundamentals of data structure and their applications essential for the programming or problem solving. So what you are going to gain from this particular module? After studying this module, you can acquire knowledge of various types of data structures, operations and algorithms. These are the different contents you have in data structures Module 1. So, you have three different chapters over here. In the first chapter, you are going to study the classification, operations, all those things. And in the second chapter, you are going to study something about the array. And in the third chapter, you are going to study the strings. Now, let us define the data structure. So, before defining the data structure, let me tell something about the data. So, we all know that data is the smallest part or smallest unit of programming, right? Any programming language, if you consider, data is the smallest unit. So, without data, you cannot further proceed with the program. So, if you collect the data together and if you give some structure to that, then you are going to get a outcome, right? So, data structure, it is nothing but the arrangement of data or organizing the data in a systematic way and accessing those data and giving those data to some particular program to get some output. So, if you consider this diagram, you can see the algorithm and the data structure together forms the program, right? So this is how you can define the data structure. Now this is the classification of data structure, where you can see there are two different types of classification: primitive data structure and non-primitive data structure. So primitive data structure is a basic data structure where you can see all the primitive data types like integer, floating point, characters and pointers. So without primitive data structure, you cannot further proceed with the data, the programming. Non-primitive data structure, it is nothing but the data structure which is derived from the primitive data structure. So non-primitive data structure, if you want to get some data structures right, like array, list or files, it can be accessed by the by using this primitive data structure. So what in the non-primitive data structure, you have three different types. One is array, list and file. So array is nothing but the collection of similar data types together in one single structure. We are calling it as array. Similar data type, that is, if you have integers, then collection of integers, we call it as integer array. Collection of characters, we call it as character array. Like that you are going to do arranging in a systematic way, that is called as array. What about list? List is nothing but you are arranging some particular data types or data in a particular manner. So we have two types of list: linear list and non-linear list. The linear list is nothing but arranging the data in a linear fashion, and non-linear list, arranging the data in a non-linear fashion. So linear list, you have the example of stack and queues, where all the data has been arranged in a linear manner. And non-linear list, you have the example of graph and trees, where all the data are not arranged in linear fashion. And the next thing you have under non-primitive data structure is files. File is nothing but the collection of records. How you will get the records? You will get the records using fields. So what you mean by field? Field is nothing but the collection of data. So without data you cannot form the file. So collection of data we call it as field. Once again, collection of fields we call it as record. Collection of records we are calling it as files. So using files you can do any operations. So all these things are the non-primitive data structure. So next, here you can see some of the example of all those data structures, whatever we have discussed in the previous slide. So you can see the stack, which is arranged in a linear fashion. So I can call it as linear data type. Even queue is in a linear fashion, horizontal fashion. So we can call it as linear data type. But if you consider graph and trees, it is not in the linear fashion. So it is non-linear list. So let us go to the next slide. The operations of data structure. You have these seven different general operations of data structure. Where, what do you mean by creation? Creation is nothing but creating a data structure. That means you are going, if you have some data with you and you are going to create a particular structure out of it. So that is that operation we call it as creation. Then traversing, you have a set of data with you. You are going to traverse from one node to one data to another data, and this traversal can be used for some purpose, like you can display all the data whatever you have, or you can search the data by traversing. All those things can be done using traversing. So searching, as I told, you are going to traverse to the nodes and searching a particular key from that particular data structure. We call it as searching operation. What do you mean by insertion? Insertion in the sense you have already a set of data, you want to insert more. That operation we call it as insertion operation. Deletion, you have a set of data, you are going to delete some data from it. We call it as deletion operation. Sorting. Sorting is nothing but if you have a jumbled set of data, arranging those data in a particular manner so that you can access it easily. What do you mean by merging? You have different set of data, you are going to merge it together to get one single outcome. We are calling it as merging operation. So next you have the concept of array. So array is nothing but, as I told, it is a collection of same data types. So array is a data structure that can store a fixed size sequential collection of elements of the same type. So you have to underline this, that is same type, because in the array you cannot see a different data types. It should be similar data types, like integer array, floating point array, character array. All those things are the examples for array. So you can see here these values inside the, this is an example for array where these values are the data which you are going to assign to the array, and these 0, 1, 2, 3, all those things are the name given to the particular position where you have stored the data. So we call it as array index. So obviously array consists of two different things. One is index and the data or value. So index is nothing but the value given to the position and the name given to the position, and value is nothing but data stored in that particular position. How we can represent the linear array in the memory? So linear array can be declared using this particular syntax: data type, name and size. So data type is the type of data. For example, here I have taken int. The name is name given to the particular array. Here I have given the name for the array as marks, and size is nothing but what exactly, how many elements you want to store inside the array. So here I had given size as 10. So I can store 10 elements in the array. So these are all these Markov 0, 1, 2, 3, all these are the index of array, and these are the space where you can store your elements. Now how we can calculate the address of array element? How we can calculate the address of the array element? So here you have a formula like A of k is equal to BA of A, where A is the array, k is the index of the element, and BA is the base address. Base address is nothing but the first address or first position of the array. Then you have W, where W is the size of one element in the memory. For example, if you have integer, then the size of W is nothing but 2 bytes. Now what do you mean by k? K is the index of the element. K minus lower bound. Lower bound is nothing but the smallest, the first position of the array. So here, if you consider this particular array example, you can see Markov 0, Markov 1, all these index, and you can see the base address as 1000. In the example, I have mentioned the base address as 1000. So it will start from 1000, and size of integer is 2. As we have declared marks as integer, the size of integer is 2. So that means W is 2 now, right? Base address is 1000, W is 2. Then what is K? Index of the element, right? So I want to calculate the address of marks of 4. So K is nothing but 4 here. So 4 minus lower bound. What do you mean by lower bound? Lower bound is the first position, that is 0th position. So index of the array, start always keep it in mind, index of the array will be starting from 0th position to n minus 1th position. So obviously the lower bound will be, most of the times it will be 0. So you are going to get 1008 as the address which we have here, right? So this is how we can calculate the address of the array element. Now calculating the length of an array. So length of the array can be calculated using upper bound minus lower bound plus 1. For example, the same array we can consider. So upper bound is 7 and lower bound is 0, right? So 7 minus 0 plus 1, you will get 8. So you can store total of 8 elements in the array. So length of the array is 8. So this is how you can calculate the length of the array. Now how we can initialize the arrays during declaration? So you have this syntax: type array name size is equal to list of values. So you can give the list of values like this during declaration if you are going to initialize. This is how you are going to do. So for example, here you can see the mark 0 to 4, 90, 80, 82, 78, 95 and 88. Now how we can declare? If I declare it like this, if I declare it like this, int marks of this, then everything will be stored over here, right? 90, 45, 67, 85 and 78. If I write int marks of 5 is equal to only 2 values, then what will happen? Only those 2 values are stored in the array, rest everything will be zeros. Then if I declare without any size, if I declare just a square bracket, then you can have any number of elements, but maximum size you need to specify initially. And if I write like this, marks of 5 and 0, all the 5 position will be marked with the 0. So this is how you can initialize the array during declaration. Now how you can do it during the how you can input the values from the keyboard? not during declaration, how you can do it while programming. Now this is how you can declare the array. Marks of 10 is the array and I is a pointer. We are going to use it in the loop. So I start from 0 to 10 values, that is 0 to 10, that means 0 to 9 is the index, right? So what you are going to do, you are going to read it using scanf, read the values, that is percentage d is the format specifier for integer array. So integer, you are going to read it using ampersand symbol. The scanf syntax, I hope all of you know the scanf syntax. You are going to read the array elements using this code. Now this is the last slide I have in this video. So how we can calculate the address in the two-dimensional array? Before that, what do you mean by two-dimensional array? In the one-dimensional array, you have either row or column, that is elements are arranged either in horizontal way or vertical way, any way is fine in the array concept. So that is linear array, or that is one-dimensional array. Now what do you mean by two-dimensional array? In the two-dimensional array, you will be having row as well as column. So there are two indices, one is row index and one more is column index. If you see this diagram, you can see a matrix which is nothing but the two-dimensional array. So you can represent it using row major arrangement and column major arrangement. Row major arrangement in the sense, you are going to take the row first, 8654, that row 0, then row 1 is 2197, that you are going to write in the row 1, and 3642 in the next row. So this type of representation we call it as row major representation. And column major, you consider the first column 823, then 616, then 594, finally 472. So this arrangement we call it as column major arrangement. So I hope this, all these things are clear for you. We'll meet in the next particular next session, next video. Thank you.